starvation, hunger, depression, the fear of body image, a terror in which every anorexic teen in America faces on a daily basis. And treatment will determine whether or not this terror ends. And because of that, we are here proposing the question of whether or not more social therapy should be integrated into hospitals and clinics to help anorexia nervosa in teens. And to begin, Kennedy will go into depth explaining anorexia nervosa.
Anorexia nervosa is a disease in which people obsess about their weight and what they eat. Anorexia has the highest death rate than any other eating disorder. This most commonly targets adolescents from the ages of 15 to 19 years of age.
So some other possible solutions that were considered were to integrate more individual therapy into hospitals and clinics, which is not a social therapy because it's only one-on-one with another person, and to lower the cost of the treatment of anorexia nervosa.
Alexis, with a solution on the issue.
More social therapy programs should be integrated to hospitals and clinics so that, along with the insurance that is needed for these treatments, so that there can be improvements in health, there can be enhancements of social skills, and there can be the lowerment of money spent on treatment costs.
Through the scientific lens, social therapy is beneficial because it reduces the symptoms associated with anorexia nervosa. One effect of anorexia nervosa is severe weight loss, which can lead to bone loss as well as malnutrition. However, according to Kevin Gable, who is a lecturer in the Department of Psychiatry, in a study conducted to compare multiple family therapy to individual therapy, multiple family therapy restores more weight at a 99.6% compared to a 95.4% in individual therapy. Social therapy restores weight at a much faster level compared to individual therapy, which would limit the risk associated with anorexia, at the same time allowing teens into earlier remission. In addition to this, Marina Sepúlveda, who is a postgraduate in the Master of Clinical Psychology and Health, her and her colleague did a comparison of family therapy from pre and post treatment. From pre and post treatment, there are a decrease in the severity of the symptoms from a mean of 4.5 that decreases to 3.8 at the end of the treatment. In addition to this, there are also significant improvements on the weight concern, eating concern, and as well as eating restraint. And by reducing these symptoms, it will overall set every teen on the path of recovery while at the same time reducing relapses, since these symptoms, who are the major causes of anorexia nervosa, will be reduced. And Kennedy will now look at the issues through the social and cultural lens.
Every day, many anorexics suffer from social anxiety and isolation from the real world due to the severity of their symptoms. This causes them to miss out on a good education, quality family and friend bonding time. Thus, the best way to help the future generation succeed in the real world is to have support group therapies. According to Dr. Anja Malmendier, a lead psychiatrist in Kent and Medway Hospital, she discusses how support group therapy enables new friendships and encourages a healthy recovery and allows for a healthy recovery. Overall, it not only teaches these anorexic patients how to socialize and interact with other people their own age, but it leads them to an early and healthy remission. Additionally, Donald Inbody, a lead psychiatrist as well, discusses what goes on in these support group therapies that makes it so effective. During the support group therapies, the patients have to share past experiences, emotions, thoughts, and feelings. Thus, it creates a strong, trusting bond and allows them to learn key socializing skills that they'll need in the real world.
Alexis, through the economic lens.
The expenses of maintaining anorexia nervosa treatment. According to Ruth Strangle-Morey, a clinical psychologist, hospitalization has been advocated as an efficient and cost-effective treatment program, meaning that because of social programs and the health insurance with it, the costs are lowered, are lowered, making hospitalization more common for anorexic teens, letting them get help. Also, if health cost care reform passes, patients may be able to have comfort that pre-existing conditions may be grounds for exclusion, which was stated by the Eating Disorders Review, which consists of eating disorder experts. This quote is representing that if the patients have health care, then the families and patients themselves won't have to worry about cost as much as they would if they did not have the health care that is needed that comes with the social therapies.
Delcy with the opposing argument.
So according to Valdo Rica, who is a researcher, he stated that that during the process of individual therapy, that there was no significant amount of deaths, and they wanted to see more progress at follow-ups. And including more individual therapy could be a good solution because it could help teens based on their preference whether they would want to talk one-on-one with a therapist or psychologist. And another solution that was considered was to lower the cost of anorexia nervosa treatment. And this could be a good solution because lowering the cost would help the parents of anorexic teens, helping them pay the bills for the medical treatments that their child is receiving. And according to Ruth Strigelmore, who is a clinical psychologist, he stated that in America, cost and lack of insurance is a barrier for the United States. And a downfall to this problem is that the United States is already having this problem, and there's already a problem, and it hasn't been solved yet.
Overall, many people favor individual therapy because it doesn't involve a lot of people, thus making it beneficial for families who has only a single parent, since that parent can both maintain the family's income as well as treat their child. However, as stated earlier, it is found unsuitable, and there are many conflicts that arise. Many others also advocated for lowering the cost, which is beneficial since less money will be spent for treatment. However, people are paying, regardless of the decrease in price, without insurance coverage, the price is still unaffordable to many people, and that people are paying for ineffective treatment. However, if more social therapies and higher insurance coverage are integrated to solve the issue, there will be less money spent and better treatment. Better treatment means better future, and there are only few limitations that arise. Alexis will now present those limitations.
The downfalls of social therapy programs are that not all people may have enough money, even with the help of health insurance, to pay the existing bills that are not covered by health insurance, because they could either be unemployed at the moment, or they could have other health bills to be paying, like the health insurance itself. They do have to pay those types of bills. Also, some people may not be suitable for social therapies because not all anorexic patients have the problem of social skills. Some are fine with social skills, it's just body image. Also, it may take a while for the government to set these programs into place because of funding and the time that it takes to build them, and the space to have it built.
Kennedy with the implications.
Real world implications.
will benefit tremendously from this program because it will enhance their social skills, which then would mean that these families would be on a time schedule since they have to perform different exercises during different parts of the day, hence the clock. Additionally, less anorexics would self-harm because they would have a better mental state due to these programs. Lastly, and most importantly, it is suitable to everyone across America since it will be all over America and it's very affordable.
Delcy with the wrap-up.
So if our solution were to happen, the amount of deaths would decrease, the anorexia levels in America would lower, there would be closer bonds between the teens and families and friends. Also, the anorexic teen would acquire better social skills from attending these social therapies, and there would be less money spent on programs. And ways to help the anorexic teens of America is to go to hospitals and see if any programs are in place and talk to maybe some anorexic teens who are in these programs and see how they view as the program is going and see if you can get signatures and try to go to City Hall and make this suggestion to help the anorexic teens of America.
Lynn, describe how the content of the teen presentation was changed as a result of group discussion.
So in the beginning, when we started choosing our research topic, our research question, we thought, and like choosing the lens, we thought that by including a futuristic lens, it would overall strengthen our argument, since it would show that our solution will also benefit in the future and how it affects the future, which would all overall make it more convincing. However, through a group discussion, and by the way, Delcy had the futuristic lens, and through a group discussion, we realized that Delcy's research incorporated a lot of our information, such as she also had stuff from like the weight, she also had stuff about social as well as the cost, and we realized that if we incorporated her lens, it would make our presentation repetitive. So we decided to exclude her lens.
Kennedy, describe an argument from one of your partner's individual reports that made you think differently about your team's solution or conclusion.
So Alexis's argument was the economic lens, and it made me think differently about the topic because I didn't realize how much money that it took to have these programs set in place, and I didn't know that how many different types of costs that were needed, such as indirect costs and direct costs, which is costs for the actual treatment inside the hospital, and then the cost that's outside of the hospital.
Alexis, having finished your project, what, if anything, do you consider to be a gap in your team's research that, if addressed, would make you feel more confident about your conclusion?
I feel like if we would have added a little bit more evidence on how the teens end up after the therapy, it might have made our argument a little bit stronger, showing that what we're saying is true, that it does help their social skills, and it does financially help the families, and it does improve their health. That's what I think would be a little bit changed if we would have redone that.
Delcy, reflecting on your colleague's work, which one had the greatest impact on your overall understanding of the problem your group identified?
So the partner's argument and research that had the greatest impact on my understanding was Lynn's, because it was showing how the teens and the health and the certain different health aspects affect the teen and how it could relate to my lens and how it would affect the future and the future health of the anorexic teens.